Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. By now you are well conversant with the biodiversity, its types, its values and different threats to the biodiversity. You are also well conversant with different mechanism or different efforts that can be done for the conservation of biodiversity. At national and international, there are a number of agencies that are working in the field of biodiversity conservation. And one such agency is IUCN, and that the full form of that is International Union for Conservation of Nature. So in this module, we shall be studying about International Union for Conservation of Nature, that is IUCN, and different categories of threatened species that are given by the IUCN. So the learning objective of this module are to learn about IUCN and different categories of threatened species. The International Union for Conservation of Nature, IUCN, is an international organization working in the field of nature conservation and sustainable use of natural resources. It is the leading international environmental organization. Its headquarters is at Glan, Switzerland. Let's have a look on the history of this organization. The IUCN was founded on 18th October 1948 at Fontainebleau, that is in France, and is the world's most comprehensive inventory of the global conservation status of species. This organization is funded by governments, member organizations, bilateral and multilateral agencies, etc. It is the world's main authority on the conservation status of species. Its headquarters is now in Glan, Switzerland. India became a state member of IUCN in 1969. The office of IUCN in India is located in New Delhi, and the same was established in 2007. IUCN has produced several key international environmental agreements, and these include the Convention on Biological Diversity, that is CBD, then the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species, that is CITES. Dear students, please have a look on the CITES, because this is a very important treaty or agreement. Then the World Heritage Convention and the Ramsar Convention on Wetlands. You know that Ramsar Convention was given in 1971, and that is related to the conservation of this wetland and waterfowl. Let me have a look on the functions of IUCN. IUCN is best known for compiling and publishing the IUCN Red List of Threatened Species. This list assesses the conservation status of species worldwide. The mission of IUCN is to persuade, promote and help societies to preserve the diversity of nature. Its aim is to protect nature and promote its sustainable utilization of natural resources. It also integrates matter of poverty alleviation, climate change and biodiversity and gender equality. What are the activities that are taken up by the IUCN? IUCN works over a wide range of themes related to conservation, environmental and ecological issues. Some of the activities include business and biodiversity, climate change, ecosystem management, forest conservation, protection of marine and polar environments, IUCN Global Species Program, water conservation and management, natural world heritage sites, and IUCN Global Protected Area Program. Dear student, please visit the website of IUCN and have a look upon different activities undertaken by IUCN, and also try to find out that what kind of work is going on behalf of IUCN in different parts of the world. IUCN has generated a number of resources. So some of the major resources generated by IUCN include conservation tools, IUCN Red List of Threatened Species, IUCN Red List of Ecosystem, and key biodiversity areas. Let me discuss them one by one, that what these are. First of all, let me take conservation tools. The key objective of IUCN is to share the knowledge. IUCN's knowledge products consist of conservation databases and tools. The major list of conservation databases developed by IUCN is given here, and this includes the IUCN Red List of Threatened Species, the IUCN Red List of Ecosystem Assesses, the World Database on Key Biodiversity Areas, Protected Planet Assesses, and Ecolex. Ecolex is a gateway to environmental law. The next is IUCN Red List of Threatened Species. The IUCN Red List of Threatened Species was created in 1964. It is one of the most well-known objective assessment systems for classifying the status of plants, animals, and other organisms threatened with extinction. The IUCN unveiled this assessment system in 1994. It contains explicit criteria and categories to classify the conservation status of individual species on the basis of their probability of extinction. IUCN has categorized the species into 9 groups, and these 9 groups are shown in this figure. And these categories include, let me start from the left side, extinct, extinct in the wild, critically endangered, endangered, vulnerable, near threatened, least concern, data deficient, and not evaluated. Dear students, these categories and have been discussed in detail in other modules. Otherwise also, lot of information, lot of data about these categories is available on the internet. So please try to find out that what kind of species are there in which list. Now, question is, what is the criteria for the classification of different species? The various criteria used for the classification of species include, the IUCN system uses a set of 5 quantitative criteria to assess the threat or extinction risk of a given species. And these 5 quantitative criteria include the rate of population decline of a given species, the geographic range, population size, species size or its habitat area, whether these about quantitative properties indicate high probability of extinction of species in the wild. In this table, different IUCN categories along with their description are given. The first category is extinct. A taxon is extinct when there is no reasonable doubt that the last individual has died. And the example of this is dodo. You can find many more examples. Then extinction in the wild. A taxon is extinct in the wild when it is known only to survive in the cultivation, in captivity, or as a naturalized population or populations, well outside the past range. Then critically endangered category. A taxon is critically endangered when it is considered to be facing an extremely high risk of extinction in the wild in immediate future. The example is ghadiyal. Then endangered species. A taxon is endangered when the best available evidence indicates that it is facing a risk of extinction and is become less in number. The example of this category is tiger. Then vulnerable. A taxon is vulnerable when it is not critically endangered or endangered, but it facing a high risk of extinction in the wild in the medium term future. The example of this category is polar bear. Another next category is near threatened. A taxon is near threatened when it has been evaluated against the criteria which we have discussed just now, 5 quantitative criteria, but doesn't qualify for critically endangered, endangered, but is close to qualifying for or is likely to qualifying for a threatened category in the near future. The example of this category is blue-billed duck. Least concerned? A taxon is least concerned when it has been evaluated against the criteria and doesn't qualify for any of the category. So widespread and abundant taxa are included in this category. Then data deficient category. A taxon is data deficient when there is inadequate information to make a direct or indirect assessment of its risk of extinction based on its distribution and or population status. A taxon in this category may be well studied and its biology is well known, but appropriate data on abundance or distribution is lacking. Data deficient is therefore not a category of threat. The last category is not evaluated. A taxon is non-evaluated when it has not yet been evaluated against these criteria. Second resource generated by IUCN is IUCN Red List of Ecosystems. The IUCN Red List of Ecosystems is a global standard to assess the conservation status of ecosystems. It is applicable at local, national, regional, and global levels. It is based on a set of rules or criteria for performing evidence-based scientific assessments of the risk of ecosystem collapse as measured by reductions in geographical distribution or degradation of the key processes and components of ecosystems. Major targets of IUCN Red List of Ecosystems. This classify and list the world's ecosystem and document their status. Focus not only on threatened ecosystem but also on those are in good condition as a result of active management, and so highlight best practices used in the ecosystem management. This has established a secretariat to manage the Red List of Ecosystem processes in collaboration with the IUCN Red List of Threatened Species. Enhanced technical and institutional capacity for ecosystem red listing at national, regional, and global levels. Develop strong linkage between good ecosystem management and sectors which are not necessarily focused on conservation. The examples are national and economic planning, livelihood improvement, and the private sector. The another resource is IUCN 2017 to 2020 program and future prospects. The IUCN programs working for people and nature provides the framework for planning, implementation, monitoring, and evaluating the conservation work undertaken by the commissions and the secretariat with and on behalf of IUCN members. The IUCN program 2017 to 2020 has three main priority areas, and these areas include valuing and conserving nature. Second is promoting and supporting effective and equitable governance of natural resources. And third is deploying nature-based solution to societal changes. The aim of IUCN is that up to 2025 to assess the global conservation status of all of the world's terrestrial, freshwater, marine and subterranean ecosystems and to create the first IUCN Red List of Ecosystems of the world. At present, IUCN program 2017 to 2020 was approved by member organization at IUCN, and the same is given here in this flow chart. And this gives, in 2008, IUCN process began at Barcelona. 2012-2014, IUCN Red List of Continental Ecosystem of the America. Then 2015, standardized protocols and online tools fully available. Then 2009, IUCN Red List established. 2010, draft Red List categories and criteria. 2011, global consultation and testing initiated. 2012, synthesis and presentation at JASU. Then 2015 to 2020, program is expansion to other biological realms and regions initiated. Then 2002-2025 program is first global IUCN red list of ecosystem completed. So dear students, to summarize this module. In this module, we have learned what is IUCN and what are different kind of activities undertaken by IUCN and what resources have been generated by IUCN. We have also learned about different categories or the red list of the threatened species given by IUCN. And last, I'll request you, please visit the website of IUCN. You will find over there lot of information about conservation of biodiversity and the different efforts or different resources generated by IUCN. Thank you.